So when did you find him?
About half an hour ago.
Has Inspector Munro been informed?
Yeah, he's on his way.
Any ID?
Yes, there was a driving license in his inside pocket. Straight drop. Plenty of height.
Yeah.
Has to be a jumper.
Death confirmed. 8:51 a.m.
So what do you think?
I think we should get photos and forensic out here before we get them moved.
Yeah, better safe than sorry.
Alan? That body that was found out by the Lees, is it right his name was Tomes? Ronald Tomes?
Going by the property he had on him, yes.
Anything sus?
I wouldn't like to say, Gov. I mean, it could have been suicide, but he seems to have been on foot and he was a long way from home.
Yeah. Well, you know what it's like with jumpers. They like to get it right. I've known some of them go miles to do it.
What floor do we want?
The sixth.
I might have known.
Mrs. Ruddy?
Yes.
Sun Hill Police, you reported a break-in.
Come on, Roddy.
These are just the items we found on him, sir. As it's a fall, the pathologist wants the clothes left on the body until the PM. According to his driver's licence, he lived at Marsh Beck.
All Hallows Terrace, Marsh Beck.
That's right, yeah.
And before that, he had a house in Pink's Lane.
You mean you knew him, sir?
Ronnie Tomes? Yeah, I knew him. Believe it or not, he used to be a circus performer. High wire act. Then he gave it up and drifted into crime. Became a high wall man.
Any convictions?
Yeah, a couple. Well, that was a long time ago.
You see, what worries me, well, it worries both of us, is that whoever it is must have broken in while we were asleep. We always go to bed early.
Yeah, but broken in where exactly?
The back bedroom.
It's a room we don't use very much now. Not since our daughter left home. There.
Mind the glass, Polly. So what's out there then, Mr. Ruddy?
Out there? Nothing.
There's no balcony?
No, nothing.
I think we'd better give Soko a call.
Yeah, right. Polly, you'd better give the parents a call and all. It was six floors up, Mr. Ruddy. How could anybody break in through here?
I don't know, but they did.
Are you sure the wind didn't break the window? I mean, it must blow a bit up here.
Oh, no. Things were stolen.
What things?
The unbadged single goblet was on there.
Oh, what?
Hornchurch, 1987.
Oh, no, it was before that. You went over to Romford in 1987.
Did I?
Bank holiday Monday.
Oh, yes. The Billericay Legion Bowl was on there. Mm. Only a small thing.
We kept odds and ends in it.
The rest were in here. On that shelf. Two cups, a tankard and a little figure on a stand.
What are we talking about? Trophies?
Yes.
What for?
For bowls. Singles matches. I used to do a bit.
Are they worth much?
Oh, no. They're just cheap things. Not like club presentations. They were just put together after a whip round, a sort of day out prize, if you like, for the singles winner. We used to say the inscriptions were worth more than the trophies.
The West Thurrock one was nickel-plated silver.
No, it wasn't worth anything. No bigger than an egg cup.
So you're saying all that was taken were these trophies?
Yes, and a bin liner. Well, I left one out for the morning. It was gone.
Yeah, well, do you have any valuables in the flat?
Valuables? No, I don't think we've got anything valuable.
There were those bits of jewellery that belonged to your mother.
Yes, but they're not worth much.
What about money? Do you keep much money in the flat?
No. Just enough to pay the bills, that's all.
Hiya.
Where are we?
Number 100, sixth floor.
Oh, great.
No, you wait till we get up there. You're going to love this one. Excuse me? Is this Ronnie Times' house?
He's not in.
No, but is this his house?
Who are you?
Detective Inspector Burnside. Sun Hill Police.
He doesn't own the house, he only rents it.
Thanks.
If you can call it a house, it's more like a rabbit hutch.
So, who are you?
My name's Denise.
Are you a relative?
Nope.
Girlfriend?
Well, I share the bills and I share his bed. I suppose that makes me his girlfriend. Look, I can't help you. Whatever he did wrong, he did it a long time ago. He told me that.
And, you believed him?
Yeah. We get on all right together. There's not what you could call love between us, but we get on all right. He's been kind to me. And I do my best to keep him out of trouble.
What sort of trouble?
Drinking. Mixing with the wrong sort of people.
So who are the wrong people?
The deadbeats he drinks with, given half a chance. They're no good to him. They try and kid him he's the star he once was. But he isn't. It's just that he still likes an audience. Any audience. But all he's got left are the people he drinks with.
And you.
Oh, yeah. And me. Look. Is that it? Only I've got things to do. I was working late last night.
Where's that?
Behind the bar at the Cromwell.
Is that where you met Ronnie? At the Cromwell?
Yeah. Life and soul of the place. Buying rounds for all them wasters and takers.
Bit of a mug with his money, is he?
What money he has got, yeah.
Where's he work?
He does a bit of jobbing here and there. Driving and that. Delivering cars. Look, why do you want to know all this?
You just told me that you kept him out of trouble.
That's right, I do. When I can.
You let him down last night then, didn't you?
Last night?
He didn't come on, did he?
All right, what's he been up to?
You tell me.
Look, I don't own him. We live together, that's all. I do my best, but I can't watch him all the time, can I? It's his life.
Not anymore.
What do you mean?
We need you to come and identify him, love. He's dead. You sure you're all right? Where did he go last night? Do you know?
No, no idea.
He didn't tell you? What about these drinking partners of his?
It could have been with them, I suppose.
What, in the Cromwell?
No, he wouldn't have gone to the Cromwell last night. I was working there. He wouldn't have wanted me to see him.
Was he in any kind of trouble?
He could have been, I suppose. He used to tell me to be careful who I opened the door to.
Why?
Some of the people he was driving for, they weren't very happy with him.
These cars, were they stolen?
I don't know, do I? Why would he want to kill himself?
Well, like you say, he hadn't got a lot going for him these days.
He did. He heard me.
Are you still in the vicinity of Briar's Lane, Kath?
Yes, Sarge.
Good. I want you to go to the penthouse at number 83, that's 83 Ferryside, and speak to a Mr. Goodson. He reckons he's had an intruder on the roof.
A tightrope walker.
Yeah, and a trapeze artist. And a good villain too, for the short time he was at it.
Sounds like you had a lot of respect for him.
I did, yeah. I remember when this computer warehouse got done. Shanks Mills Wharf. My old boss, well, he was my oppo then. He couldn't fathom out how anybody managed to climb up and get in. It was like the south face of the Eiger. But I knew. I'd sussed it. You see, I knew Ronnie's form. I'd sat in the front row of the big top at Peddler's Fields with my sister's kids. And I'd seen Ronnie in action on the high wire. That's how I knew when the time came. That's how I helped nick him.
Was there anything suspicious about the circumstances?
No, I don't think so. Alan Woods had his doubts at first. But I've spoken to Ronnie's living girlfriend. It seems Ronnie was on a real downer these days. Pushing 60, no real job, no future. Living in a two up, two down, drinking with a load of deadbeats.
Would that be enough for him to kill himself?
Yeah. Knowing him, I think it's very possible. See, he was a showman. He needed an audience. Couldn't have been much fun being out of the spotlight.
So, when's the post-mortem?
12:30.
One jacket, damaged fibre, foreign debris in fibre. Blood stains on shoulders and front of jacket, probably as a result of massive hemorrhaging. Jacket removed for forensic examination.
All right, Pat.
Hello, Frank. You're gonna need to get dressed up unless you want to wait.
I'll wait.
I heard some sounds during the night. It woke me up.
What kind of sounds?
As if someone was on the roof, walking across it. I put all the lights on, made a lot of noise, as you people say we should do, and there were no more sounds.
And what time was this, sir?
Oh, God knows. It was in the middle of the night. I thought I was imagining things, so I went back to sleep.
You've been up on the roof?
This morning, yes. Well, I'm working from home, so I decided to pop up for some fresh air. I'll show you what I found.
Right.
At first, I thought it might be some kids playing some kind of a joke, but not in the early hours of the morning. On there.
North Auckland and 88?
Yes, I didn't touch it. I thought I'd better leave it where it was.
Any idea who it might belong to?
No idea at all. Anyway, I thought burglars were supposed to take property, not bring it with them.
I've completed the external examination. I'll know a bit more when I've made an internal one. Then I can let you have a full report as soon as the coroner's had his copy.
Well, what more is there to know? He jumped off a bridge.
No. Your man didn't jump off the Lees Bridge.
What?
Well, for a start, I'd say he'd been drinking a fair amount, and his injuries are consistent with him having fallen from a very high place onto a hard surface.
But he was found on soft ground under that bridge.
Maybe. That's not where he died.
Sierra Oscar 85 from Sierra Oscar.
Yes, Sierra Oscar 85.
He's still out near the bypass, George.
Yeah, we're just leaving it now, Sarge. Heading south on Elms Lane.
Can you get yourself over to the Linlow plant hire site at 3 Mile Lane? Contact the site manager, a Mr. John Jarvis.
He didn't fall to his death here. Where did he fall?
His girlfriend reckons he might have had some enemies.
Enemies?
Yeah.
So we could be talking about a suspicious death.
Not necessarily.
Well, he didn't exactly fall somewhere else than Crawley to die now, did he? Better inform Ahmed.
You're going to let them take over?
Well, I'll let them know what the circumstances are so far and see if they'll let us run with it till we get the PM report. When's it due?
Later on today. We didn't use the tower until later on in the morning. The ladders were locked off, and when the operator got up there, he found these things up there. Right on top, on the counter jib. Just above the cab.
What things?
I'll show you. We put them in this box. I mean, we just couldn't believe it. They were all set out up there like some sort of prize-giving ceremony.
On top of that crane?
Yes. And you say this lot was found at the top of a 90-foot crane?
Not all of them, no. That one was in the roof of a warehouse conversion.
And you say these were stolen?
We think so, sir, yes. We're having the losers in to identify them.
Where was the location of this break-in?
100 Brightstone Flats, a very high building with a sheer drop. There's no easy access. But Socko reckons the flat could have been reached from above, not below. Here's her report. She did find traces of rope fibre on the edge of the roof.
Ronnie Tomes is a joke, a waster. Denise deserves better.
Did he come in here yesterday?
For a while, yes. About 7:30. He was tanked up before he got here.
Was he on his own?
No. He had these mates with him.
What mates?
Oh, the ones he usually hangs around with. And when Ronnie has a couple of drinks inside him, he thinks he's the top act in a circus all over again. But he's not. I told him that myself.
When?
Yesterday, when he was in here. He was making a lot of noise, mouthing off about how good he used to be. I told him I wanted him out.
So when did he leave?
After about 30 minutes. Denise was due on. He wouldn't hang around while she was here.
And these mates, do you know their names?
No. They're not regulars here.
So you don't know where they live or where they work?
Oh, I know where they work. They're musicians.
Musicians?
Yes. A band.
So, where do they play? Pubs? Clubs?
No. It's not that kind of a band.
Oi, Mantovani. You got a license to work these streets?
Ah, oh, just get off out of it, will you?
Police, we'd like a word.
Don't say it, nothing, right?
We'd like to talk to you about Ronnie Tomes.
Who?
You know who we're talking about. Your mate. Or should I say ex-mate? Your drinking partner? The one you like to listen to and be with? Especially when he was buying the drinks.
What you talking about? We always stood our round.
Shut up, will you?
So, was he buying the drinks last night, as usual?
I don't know. We weren't out last night.
You were seen, pal.
Where?
In the Cromwell, with Ronnie Tomes. Before the governor kicked you out, booze to the eyeballs, all four of you. So where'd you go after that?
Nowhere. What have you got to say, Len?
Nothing. He's got nothing to say.
Len?
We've got to tell him.
You what?
He's right, you've got to tell us. Because things are looking bad for you three.
What do you mean, bad?
You were the last people to be seen with Ronnie last night. He was found dead this morning in suspicious circumstances. So we've every right to believe that you killed him.
Killed him?
No, hey, hang on a minute.
No, we never killed him.
What happened then?
He bloody fell, didn't he?
You stupid bastard.
Look, we've got to tell him. He was feeling choked for some time. Things going wrong for him and that. And, well, last night sort of tipped it over, like, you know, the landlord of the Cromwell having a go at him. He sort of needed to do something, you know, to put things right.
And to prove himself?
Yeah.
So how did he decide to prove himself?
Well, after we left the Cromwell, we did the rounds, you know. And then we went up Winchill to the Mostyn Arms. You can drink late there. And when we come out, Ronnie, he could hardly stand up. But he reckoned he was all right. And he said he was going to show us that he was all right.
How?
Said he was going to walk in a straight line from one side of Sun Hill to the other.
And if a building got in the way?
He said he'd climb it.
Did he?
Of course he did. He climbed the bloody lot, didn't he?
We tried to talk him out of it, but he wouldn't listen. First off, he got into some flat.
Oh, stupid.
What's it matter now? He's dead, isn't he? No one can give him a bad time anymore. Not now. So we followed him in Ron's van. You should have seen him. I mean, the way he scrambled up them buildings.
Yeah, and the way he jumped, eh?
Jumped?
Yeah, you know, from one roof right across to the next. And he almost made it.
Almost.
He only went up this crane, didn't he? Right up the tower mast. I mean, we wanted to tell him to pack it in then, you know, call it a night for his own good. But we lost sight of him the other side of 3 Mile Lane. And when we caught up with him again, he was on top of the hydro.
Well, the multi-story car park. And then what?
Well, then he fell, didn't he?
And it didn't occur to you to report any of this?
No.
But we were scared, weren't we?
You weren't too scared to move the body. Was that because you didn't want to be involved?
Don't be stupid.
Then why move it?
Because he was our mate, that's why.
There was a lot of people knocking about, you know, kids going in and out of clubs and that. I mean, we didn't want to leave him then, not with all that going on. So we picked him up and we put him in the van.
Did anybody else see him fall?
No, only us.
So then you took him to the Lees?
Yeah, well, it was out of the way up there, wasn't it? Nobody was going to bother him up there. Ronnie Tomes. He was one of the best.